And I will also say this, and I'm not going to mention the name, but if you look at the timing of what I'm about to say, then it's left to you to decide who I'm talking about. It is a very strange thing that in our country, Nigeria, a man that was part and parcel of those that slaughtered a young man by the name of Gideon Akaluka. How many people remember Gideon Akaluka? He's from Benue State. Many people believe he was an Igbo. He's from Benue State. I did the research. You see, it was in the mid-90s, and they said that he used the Quran as toilet paper in a police station or something. And a crowd stormed the police station, dragged him out, beheaded him, put his head on a pole. He slaughtered him. And 12 people were involved that stirred up the whole crowd, 12. In fairness to the late General Abacha, the minute he heard about this, on television, everything, Abacha said, round up the leaders and execute them. I don't even want to hear anything about taking them to court, just wipe them out. But I will not tolerate Islamic fundamentalism in this country. In fairness to Abacha, he did. And they did it. Kumasi was the IG at the time. And Ribadu told me this story, and he was involved. Who Ribadu? He told me the story, others told me it got further. And they went after these people, and they killed every single one of them, except for one. That, I haven't mentioned any names. So they looked like it. Now, that person was kept in a Sokoto prison for 2 years, hidden. And they told Abacha they had already dealt with him as well. Abacha didn't know. After the 2 years, a gentleman, his name, let me not say my mind, the gentleman whose son was the bomber in
Mutala.
Now got up and went to see Abacha and said, look, that this boy is my boy, he's always been my boy. We raised him, we're close to him, and we will still need him in the future. So please, he hasn't been killed, he's still alive. We want you to just leave him and let's see the go. And we found something for him to do, and he's going to stop all this thing. But he's going to work for the North, meaning the Muslim North. They brought him out of Sokoto, Abacha agreed. They took him down to the South. And from that point, his career in the private sector went nuclear. He was planted in a particular bank. That bank was UBA. He wasn't too happy there. Abakiyari, who is now chief of staff, was there, never liked him. In fairness to Abacha, never liked him. Never liked him. And I have to say this, Kiyari is not the man many people think he is. He's actually far better. A lot of people say, well, I've known him, we're Cambridge together, and he worked in my father's office for 10 years. He's not the monster everybody thinks he is. Shua Arab, he's actually very reasonable. That's the truth. I ought to say that. He was not comfortable with this young man, because he could read him like a book. So the man was moved by the same Mutala from that place to First Bank. And of course, Mutala has massive shares in First Bank. He was taken there. When he got to First Bank, he rose through the ranks, meteoric rise, and I think I better just say the rest is history. Because I don't want anybody to say I mentioned his name in that context. But I think it's fairly clear who I'm talking about. That person became what he is today. And it's only in Nigeria. It's just only in Nigeria. And I have not just said this to him, I've said I've known him for years. I've challenged him on this on numerous occasions. And he has never replied to me because he's very uncomfortable with me. And he knows that the day he replies to me on that, I just don't want to mention his name here, that's all. I've mentioned it elsewhere. Let it not be said I said it here. That's the Nigeria we're in. So when it comes to violence, it is something that they covet, it is something they're hell-bent on doing, and I'm told that even now, that agenda is very much there. In terms of funding, Boko Haram and the Fulani herdsmen are being funded not just by elements in northern Nigeria, but also being funded by elements outside this country. ISIS is here. That is a fact we have to accept now. They are called ISWA, ISIS West Africa. They are empowering and they are funding Fulani people from different parts of Mali, from all over the West African region. They're coming here. And if you go to the Southwest today, one of the things I want to mention earlier, our forests in the Southwest have been taken over by these people. They are there out, waiting for orders. And then from time to time, they kidnap people. And of course, the money they get from the kidnapping, they recycle it back, and they use it to buy more arms and so on and so forth. The government is doing nothing about it. So that's just where we are.